Hey y'all, Irix Guy here, and this is how to set up and use the Google Advanced Protection Program. Now what I've got in my hand right here, and you can check the link within this video's description to find where to order it online, but I wanted to find a little case to carry my one of my keys around. So this particular key is the one it's got a USB, micro USB on the end, so it can be used with a USB port, but it also has Bluetooth. So this is the key that I use for Google Advanced Protection Program on my iPhone. So how do you set up and how do you use Google Advanced Protection Program? Well, the first thing you're going to need to do is enroll in the Google Advanced Protection Program. So if you've got a Google account, you know, if it's a Gmail account, maybe that's all you use. Maybe you use YouTube like I do. Maybe you use a whole bunch of other Google services as well. What this will enable you to do is harden your Google account access so that someone would have to have one of your keys to be able to log in. They couldn't just have your password. They'd have to have physically have one of your keys in their possession to authenticate with one of their devices that they're trying to log in with. So I've got this key, and then I've got a second key stored off-site in a safe, and then I've got a third key that I use for travel. In theory, once you authenticate one of your devices using this key for Google Advanced Protection Program, it may remain in there for a long period of time, but there's always a possibility that your computer may need to be re-verified, so always keep one of these keys in your possession. Again, keep one in a safe place, because if you lose all your keys, you're going to have to go through an extremely complicated process to re-verify your identity with Google. So the best thing to do is I would go more than two. Like I said, I've got three keys. So so all you do, you set up your Google Advanced Protection Program, you enroll, and when you enroll, then it'll tell you to, you know, associate your keys with the Google Advanced Protection Program. Again, this is the one that's capable of Bluetooth. So it's one that I use with my iPhone. And it's really nice because with iPhone, at least at the time of posting this, Apple Mail will work. The plethora of applications will work. So that's really nice. Now on the desktop Mac, because I enrolled in Google Advanced Protection Program, at least at the time of posting this, I cannot use the Mail account on my desktop Mac OS. And I cannot use Safari. I've got to use Chrome browser, and I've got to use gmail.com for mail, which is fine. I do most of my email from my iPhone anyway, and the iPhone Mail app currently does work with Google Advanced Protection Program. So that's how I do most of my email anyway. I mean, that could change in the future. But keep in mind, you're hardening your access to your Google account. So in my case, I use email. I use YouTube, of course. And this is just an additional layer of peace of mind. I mean, sure, most anything can be hacked, but if it requires a physical key, the probability that your Google account may become hacked is significantly reduced. So, yeah, it's really simple. You sign up for Google Advanced Protection Program. You buy a few of these keys. Again, check the link within this video's description. You can find where to order them online. I've got this one, which is the Bluetooth one. But I've got another one, it's just a little USB, it looks like a little USB thumb drive, and I've got that off-site in a safe to be safe. And then I've got another one of these so that when I'm traveling, I've always got it in my backpack with me. And that's important, you know, you may get by with two, but optimally, you may even want more than three. You know, three has been optimal for me. But since I've set this up, I've not had to re-authenticate from my iOS device, my iPhone, or my MacBook Pro. So, you know, once they were set up, because I had authenticated initially using one of these, they're called FIDO keys, you know, it's retained that. But again, always keep this with you, because if you logged out and needed to log back in, and for some reason Google didn't recognize your device, or maybe your hardware changes, maybe you upgrade something or whatever, always keep one of these with you so that you don't get locked out. but it's a really easy thing to set up. Again, keep in mind, at least at the time of posting this, if you are using third-party apps, some of those third-party apps may not work with the Google Advanced Protection Program. I haven't run into that. Well, actually, I say I haven't run into that, but I kind of did. I used Wirecast for live streaming YouTube. And the way I had originally set up Wirecast is that I authenticated through Wirecast using my Google account. But by doing so, you know, that didn't use Google Chrome browser in Mac OS. It used an internal browser type tool to authenticate. And that was not compatible with Google Advanced Protection Program. Now, of course, with that, I had a workaround. There's a different way that I can initiate a YouTube live stream, so I don't have to authenticate. So, you know, audit what you use a Google account for, and before you make the before you decide to make the upgrade to Google Advanced Protection Program, be sure that it's not going to prevent any of your existing applications that you authenticate by way of your Google ID from functioning. So, you know, just be aware of that. I'm not trying to scare anyone out of it, but just be aware of that before you decide to take the plunge, that, you know, there could be things that at least currently may not be compatible with Google Advanced Protection Program. Again, I haven't run into any problems, but check to see what all you use your Google account for and see if that may, you know, may be something that you may want to wait before you decide to upgrade to the Google Advanced Protection Program. But it's a really good program. Again, nothing is 100% secure, but the enhanced possibility of a hacker not being able to get your access to your account, that's always a good peace of mind. And, you know, having these physical keys, it may seem cumbersome. People are like, man, I don't want to have to deal with that. That's just something to lose. Again, you're going to need to be an organized person. You're going to need to have multiple keys, and you're going to need to have a high degree of certainty that at least a few of your keys are stored in different places. So let's say something catastrophic happens, like an earthquake. You don't want to lose all of your keys. You want to have at least one off-site. So, hey, tell me what you think. Again, check the link within this video's description. You can find where to order all the different types of keys. And be sure to subscribe to my channel. It's youtube.com/iRickSky. And click that little bell icon down there, and you'll be notified whenever I post another video. Thanks for watching, and y'all have a good day. Hey, y'all. iRickSky here. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to subscribe, like, and share. It's viewers like you that enable my channel to continue to grow. Thank you.